Family tradition runs deep in the blood of commercial fisherman Joel Knight. Joel's father was a commercial fisherman and passed his life knowledge down to his son, Joel. Joel has spent many hours on the ocean catching a variety of fish, which has helped put money in the bank and food on the table. The commercial vessel that Joel uses to power across the seas is like a tugboat with an overall weight of 7,000 pounds. The hull is made of thick fiberglass and powered by a strong diesel engine with a single prop. The vessel is rigged with outriggers to hand lines to catch king mackerel. When you gaze upon her deck, you can see the history of her past work. The day begins with a stop at the local fish house to stock up on ice and to complete any needed documentation. The vessel is loaded with a few 100 pounds of ice. The ice is stored in a large center bin, which will be loaded with the day's catch. It is very important to keep the fish as cold as possible to avoid spoiling and the loss of potential profit. Joel contacted me and asked if I would like to join him on a fishing run. He knew that my passion for fishing was strong and my desire to learn more about the sport of fishing was even greater. So I decided to leave the kayak parked and gear stored and join Joel for a day on the seas. The technique I have been shown is called hand lining. Hand lining is a very effective and low budget tactic for trolling for pelagic fish. There are many hazards in hand lining. As you pull the gear and line in, you pile it on the deck just behind your feet. There are risks of getting your feet or arms wrapped and getting pulled overboard by a big pelagic or line getting caught in the running gear. Joel showed me a technique that keeps you safe and is very effective in retrieving the gear and line.
pierce, running about 80 to 100 feet, showing me some tricks of the trade, what he's doing to catch kingfish and stuff. We definitely filled up the box with a lot of kingfish. Definitely a fun trip. Learning a lot. We're out here hand lining the kingfish in. As you can see, I got gloves on to protect my hands. His hands are all beat up, toughened up from all the years of commercial fishing. We've definitely seen a lot out here. Saw some porpoise. We're running north along the reef system. It's really neat. Great day of fishing. A little bit of weather turned really crappy on the way back in. Wind kicked up high out of the east, as you saw the storm coming in out of the west. So we caught a total of about 10 kingfish and 5 bonito. We did really good today. Thanks for watching.
Subscribe to ESA channel so you can be alerted when episode 2 of Chasing Kings or any of our other wild adventures.